in our prayers, let me invite you to just consider the prayers that are coming from within your heart. A prayer for yourself, a prayer for a loved one, a prayer for our church and our city, a prayer for our nation. The prayer for our nation and the international community around our nation. God of grace and wisdom, you created the sun, moon, and the wonders of the world. You, in your mercy, created each one of us, granting us an opportunity to a lifetime utilizing our God-given talents, serving you and the community around us. We thank you, O God, for life and all its possibilities. Today we hear in the gospel about Jesus' joy, his determination to offer his message of love and salvation. He took time to heal people who need to be healed and restored. We realize in our daily lives how much we need the message of the gospel directing us, reassuring us, and inspiring us. We realize we need your healing presence to heal our physical and spiritual wounds. In our modern day struggles, we experience spiritual exhaustion from hate and anger, watching the injustice, inequity, and abuse of power. More than ever, we need your light to drive away the darkness in our midst. Lift us from our brokenness, misery, and suffering, and restore us to health, wellness, and wholeness. Often we are in the middle of life's greatest challenges. We need the best self in us to be in charge of these struggles. But reacting to challenges and losing our focus, we are less than often when we are most vulnerable. We act on our reaction rather than our wisdom. May we live our lives offering our love and our best thinking for the problems that affect us and affect the people around us. Guide our national and local leaders not to work on their own self-interest, but to care for the welfare of the people who they are elected to serve. We pray for the ongoing efforts in Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands to bring medical help and basic necessities to people who have lost much. We remember now people who have been affected by the train-related derailment in Columbia, South Carolina. We include in our prayers all those who have been affected by the boat accident in Morocco, Spain's North African waters, and the shooting in Italy targeting immigrants. We pray for each one of us seeking you this morning. Bless our lives. Hear our prayers for our loved ones, far and near. Hear our prayers for our families and communities. Empower us to give and receive love. May we generously give and serve wholeheartedly, guided by your Holy Spirit. Bless this, our worship service, and make it a meaningful service for each of us. We remember at this time Amy Stabner's family mourning the loss of their loved one in Alice. We pray for people who have requested prayers for their healing and comfort. We remember now Betty Keebler, Pat Benko, Rebecca Colturner, Linda Cropper, Rebecca Flowers, Christine Cangella, Bill Connolly. Gracious God, hear all our prayers, our spoken prayers as